Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Dave back with another lifetime deal review. Today, I'm looking at ContextMinds, which is over at AppSumo, currently available as a lifetime deal. So this is a whiteboarding tool that has AI functionality as well as SEO functionality baked right in. I gotta admit, I looked at a bunch of the demo videos and I just didn't understand what it could do. So I'm gonna spend a few minutes here clarifying that for you and you can find out if it's a good fit for your business. All right, so here's the AppSumo deal page. We'll check this out a little bit later on, but I just wanna point out that all of the plans are essentially the same. They just increase the limits as you go up. I'm just using the single plan for this video. However, I did notice if you go up to plan 5, you will get unlimited everything. So if you wanna use this with clients, this might be the deal for you. We'll come back to this later on. First, let's get into the tool, see what it actually does. So here is ContextMinds. I'm logged into my account right now. You can see I have a workspace set up called Dave's Workspace. And inside of that workspace, I can build mind maps. That's essentially what we're doing here. And I can also put them into folders. So you might notice here, folder not selected. If I want to add a folder, I can click right here. I get a nice little user interface where I can add a new folder. I'm going to call it YouTube Video Ideas. There's nesting available. You can see you can add a parent folder if you'd like. For now, I'm just gonna stick with a simple folder called YouTube Video Ideas. I am now inside of that folder and I can build my own mind map inside that folder. Now, what I wanna do when I create a new mind map is give it a main topic. So in this case, I'm gonna make a mind map about WordPress video topics so that I can make more WordPress videos on this channel, right? Because we all need more WordPress content in our lives. So I'm gonna do WordPress video topics. All right. Now, the next option before I click create is for a private map. And this is on by default, which I think is a good idea. Basically, if you turn this off, then your mind map can be used in suggestions for other people using ContextMinds. This has nothing to do with sharing or using it with teammates or anything like that. It's just whether or not they're gonna basically index it and then share it with their other users. So I'm gonna leave this set to on for myself, privacy on, and let's hit create. Now it's gonna go ahead and give me a blank canvas here. And this is essentially like an infinite canvas user interface, right? So I can scroll all the way out and we can see, you know, I'm at 50% right now. You can see that I've got lots of room to work and I can essentially, I believe, grow this as large as I'd like. Just clicking right here zooms you right back into 100% and we can start to fill out our mind map. Now you can totally use this like a conventional mind mapping tool. So I've got my main topic here in the middle and maybe I wanna add some new ideas like favorite plugins or best page builders. Now this is totally fine and there are a few more unique features here where I could click on one of my concepts and then leave a note about it. So I could write some more details here if I wanted to elaborate on the best page builders, maybe the types of content I would make. And I can even nest other ideas within this main concept. So right here, I've got this little box. I can click on this and I can start to type in my other ideas like Elementor, Bricks, Beaver Builder. You get the idea. Now I've got the best page builders kind of all listed here. If I were going to make some content about this, it might be nice to have them inside of this one overarching concept. I can also label these little arrows that go from concept to concept. If I just double click on them right here, this is actually a little bit tricky with their user interface. If you click once, it opens up the note-taking portion. So you can actually leave notes on that arrow. But if you click it twice, then you can actually name the arrow. So I could say helps with. And now if I move this over there, you can see kind of the flow where the WordPress video topic helps with such and such. Obviously, this doesn't make a lot of sense. So I can double click on it and just delete it. Okay, so that is how the mind mapping feature of this tool works. It's actually pretty basic. There's nothing really you'd want to purchase a lifetime deal over in what I've just shown you. However, there is more because remember I mentioned there's AI functionality as well as SEO functionality baked right in. So we can get a lot of data and a lot of ideas in a hurry. So now I'm back to my main concept here. And if I click on suggestions over here on the left-hand sidebar, I'm gonna turn this little switch on and now I'm given a huge list of suggestions based on this original idea. So I can see I've got some options here like best practices for optimizing WordPress videos for SEO or tips for producing high quality WordPress videos. So the word video here is kind of throwing off the suggestion engine. And most of these I believe are coming from ChatGPT. I can see which ideas are coming from ChatGPT and what they call general topics right here. So if I only want to see their general topics, I'll toggle this off And then I do get a list of kind of much more general ideas. And again, a lot of them are being triggered by this word video. We get things like S-video, PAL, television. So that tells me I want to get rid of this word from my actual title. All right, so now I've changed it to WordPress training topics. And if I go ahead and sort maybe just by ChatGPT, you can see I've got a lot of pretty helpful ideas here. And if I like any of these ideas, I can add them to my mind map by just clicking on the plus button. So let's say I like this one here, using WordPress plugins. I'm gonna add that over here. And let's say customizing WordPress themes, introduction to WordPress, and WooCommerce integration. All right, so now I've added a bunch of ideas over to my mind map. I can connect these up using the up and down arrows, just drag a line to connect them up. Essentially all of the same mind mapping features we saw before, but now we're getting ideas from ChatGPT. One part of the mind map functionality I didn't mention before is that you can color code these if you'd like. So for example, let's say these were my favorite ideas. I can go ahead and grab a color tag here and say best and pick a color, like how about purple, and hit add. And now those ideas or those concepts show up as purple. Okay, so this could be a really nice way to brainstorm some ideas, get a little help from ChatGPT, and you're not stuck inside of their chat user interface. Instead, we can bring things into a malleable world where I can move them around and actually interact with them. But that's not where this tool ends. It's really just the beginning. We have other options for suggestions over here. So far, we've been looking at something called topics, but you can see there are many other choices. So for example, keywords. Let's say I'm interested in some data about keyword research under the WordPress training topics main headline. Well, I can choose to turn off ChatGPT generated keywords and instead just sort by actual search keywords. So for example, here I've selected the customizing WordPress themes concept and I'm under keywords and my filter has just search keywords. And you can see here that it's actually pulling in some SEO data. So I can see custom WordPress theme has a keyword difficulty of 30 and only 320 searches per month. So this is probably not a very good keyword for me to create content about. When I click on that keyword, I see a little bit more information. They go into more detail here. There's two different sources. We've got Keywords Anywhere as well as SpyFu. So with Keywords Anywhere, they're saying that the search volume is 390 with the competition being about 0.3. However, with SpyFu, they're saying that there's 540 searches per month and over 400 monthly clicks. So that's quite a different story. 390 total searches versus 420 total clicks. It might kind of sway you in your decision-making when you look at data from two different SEO sources in one place. So that's really nice. I can also see that this is a topic that doesn't have a ton of advertising because about 90% of the clicks are coming from organic search. So that's also very good to know if you don't plan to do PPC on this topic. Now, down below, I can see articles that are currently ranking for this keyword of custom WordPress theme. And once again, we can click on the features option here to see that we're looking at web articles from the SERPs or search engine results pages. If I wanted to see maybe some responses from Reddit, I can select this. It's going to go and query Reddit. I can turn off my SERP results. And now I just get a list of custom WordPress themes based on Reddit posts. Now, if I like this concept, if I want to hang on to some of this information, I basically have two options. First, I can, of course, add it to my mind map by clicking on the plus button right here, and it adds it as a new concept. However, I can also add it as a pinned note inside of my currently selected concept. So remember, that's the customizing WordPress themes concept. If I click the pin button right here, well, now it just showed up over here under concept notes. Now, it's kind of hard to tell. We are actually working on this concept right here. So I could choose a different one and you can see there's no concept notes. If I come back to my customizing WordPress theme, I've got the concept note. It's not going to be the entire results that we just saw. It's basically taking notes from that card. So now I can see the SEO data from that previous search. So now we've talked about topics and keyword suggestions, but there's obviously a lot more here. So let's go through them in a bit of a rapid fire fashion. So questions, this is going to be trending questions about that topic. They can either be inspired from ChatGPT or AKA written by ChatGPT, or they can be actually trending questions. So basically the Google people also asked section of Google will be pulling in questions there. So how do I create a custom WordPress theme? I can click on this, get the search engine results pages, everything that people are looking up in terms of keyword volume and you know what we just saw there. If I use ChatGPT questions, which you can see I have selected here, I get a list of some pretty helpful questions. And if I click on them, it's going to give me the search engine results for that particular question. So I could see other people that have asked that question and how it's been answered inside of other content throughout the web. And once again, you can always just grab these articles and add them right to your mind map. And if I click on this, I'm going to have the actual link then embedded right inside of my mind map. So it's just under pinned notes here and you can see the actual links. It also gets auto-tagged as an article. So now I could organize all of my articles inside of my post. These have a red color by default. All right, headings is gonna give you some heading ideas for your content. Articles is basically just the search engine results for your overall concept here. Under maps, you're gonna see other maps that people have created that maybe they set to be public. Remember when I created my map, I said it to be private so that it's not gonna show up in the results pages here. Related to that, we've got user concepts, which would be the individual cards that show up in mind maps. These would be generated manually that people had typed in. Then we have metrics, which is gonna show us the SEO data for our concept here. And then if you wanted to chat with ChatGPT about your concept, you can open this up and with a single click say, hey, write a video script for me, write an article, whatever you like, and then ChatGPT will go ahead and pump that content out for you. Of course, you can continue the conversation here and say, make this more like MKBHD. And there you go. Now we have a script in the voice of MKBHD talking about WordPress theme customization. Each map has its own settings page. We can find it right up here on the gear icon. When you click on this, you've got the ability to configure which options show up. Like if you don't want to see keyword metrics information, you can toggle that off or back on. We can also export data from our map right here. We can export it to PDF or PNG, whatever you like. You can go ahead and grab that so that you don't have to link someone directly to your account. However, if you want to do that, you certainly can hit share right here and you get a little URL that will allow you to share it. Just make sure you turn this public before you do so. You can also invite people via email to look at your map. And there's export options right here for PNG and PDF. There's also this nice HTML option if you want to embed it on your website inside of an iframe. All right, so that's ContextMinds. Let's dig into the plans and pricing, and then I'll wrap things up with my final thoughts. So currently, I'm looking at $69 one time for a single use plan. That's the one that I have. If we scroll down here to the plan details, we can see that we're going to be mapped to their pro plan. And if the name changes, you're going to get any updates that go to whatever the pro plan becomes. You can stack up to 5 codes, and that's what gets you unlimited everything. So it's going to be unlimited AI suggestions, unlimited internal usage, and unlimited SEO data. So this is really a pretty decent detail if you do a lot of keyword research. However, if you're on more of a budget like I am for this particular tool anyway, you can get 6,000 topic and keyword lookups per month, as well as 1,500 web and AI article suggestions per month and 1,500 AI prompt responses per month. That's quite a bit for most people, especially, you know, you divide that up into work days, you're not working 32 days a year. That's quite a bit per day for a single user. If you want to use this in a team, you're going to need to move up to at least a double. That gets you additional workspaces and additional users. Now you might notice that they have file uploads for each plan, 5 gigs, 15 gigs, 100 gigs. What does this actually refer to? Well, inside of the application, if you click on any given concept under notes, you can actually upload files. So the trick to this is you click on attach file, choose the file that you want to attach, and then you have to hit this little icon right here, which will attach it to the card. And then it shows up here so that anyone on your team can access any of the data that maybe you had stored in Excel or any other place that you're doing your SEO research or whatever you're using this tool for. It doesn't have to be SEO. So that's ContextMinds. Overall, a very high quality mind mapping tool. It's a bit strict in terms of what you can do because we can basically only make these bubbles. You can color code them and connect them. And that's essentially it. We can't write freeform or add stickers or colorful illustrations right to our mind map. So if that's something you want, it's not really what ContextMinds is geared towards. However, for what it does, it works pretty well. My only criticisms of the user interface are that maybe the font choice and the color selection is just a little bit difficult to read. Like this green is could have a little bit more contrast with the background. It's kind of difficult to see exactly what it says if you're a low vision or vision impaired person. So I probably refine the color choices here a little bit, make the fonts a little bit larger. One other mention about the user interface, it does snap you to other items automatically as you move your concepts around the canvas, which can feel a bit jarring once you get a few items. It'll seem like every single move you make, your idea or your concept is just snapping into place. There's a key command, Option. You hold down Option and now you can move things and place them exactly where you want. It is completely freeform. You don't have to put them on these little grids, so I can do it right in between if I want. I let go of the Option key, and then I can place the items exactly where I need. If I move around without it, you can see those lines show up, and then everything gets very, very jagged and reactionary. Overall, I'd highly recommend you check out ContextMinds and see if it's a good fit for your business. I'm gonna go ahead and score this one at 7.8. I think it's probably a good bet for most content generating businesses, and every business these days probably needs to create some form of content. So go ahead and check out the lifetime deal over at AppSumo. I'll have my affiliate link down below in the description if you want to click it before making a purchase. It helps me out to create videos like this. My name is Dave Swift. Leave me any questions or comments down below in the description. I try to get back to just about everybody. That's it for today's review. I will see you in the next one.